Hey guys, what's going on? This is Dr. Chris McKenzie, board-certified sports and orthopedic physical therapist for players in Major League Baseball, minor leagues, NCAA, and youth baseball. And today I'm going to show you a quick exercise to increase wrist power and upper extremity stability or shoulder stability to allow us to throw the ball faster. So I know that you want to learn that one. So what it looks like is this. I call it the wrist power rebounder. Pretty much you're going to grab a ball here. This is a soft weight by TheraBand. I'll post a link up where to get this below. You can just grab it on Amazon. And pretty much it looks like this. We're just going to take this ball, throw it, and then stop it. Just like that. Okay. The first time I saw this was from Kyle Bodie on drivelinebaseball.com, I believe is the website. So give credit where credit's due. Kudos, Kyle. Thank you very much. It's a great exercise. What I didn't find is the best way to progress it or to how to start it from the get-go. So I'm going to give that to you right now. So what I want you to do is, as a beginner, I want you to get down on one knee just to get the feel of this. And as a beginner, just to get the feel of this on your knee, you're going to do it for 2 sets and 10 reps. So we're just going to take this ball, throw it down, and then stop it like this. So our goal is to stop this ball from rising up and then stop it from rising our arm up, okay? That involves a great deal of co-contraction at our shoulder, a little bit less so at our elbow, and then also on the front of the elbow and the front of the wrist are the wrist flexors. Now the wrist flexors actually go into a eccentric contraction, and we know in order to create power, we need to overload the muscles eccentrically in order so they can transition back into a concentric phase to create better velocity. So wrist velocity, we know, is somewhat correlated with ball velocity. So we can't directly say that if we train our wrist to move faster, the ball will move faster, but there's a chance that it could. So we want to take every step that we can in order to make that happen. So here's what it looks like, okay? So you're going to take this ball, throw it. And a little tip here is that once you release this ball, you're gonna try to follow it. Okay, you're gonna follow this ball so the ball doesn't go up everywhere and so the ball doesn't move your arm up. So we get really good stability here, and then we want the ball to be heavy enough to produce a little bit of wrist extension here. So this ball isn't heavy enough for me even when I stand up. So after 2 sets of 10 here, you're gonna move to standing. And then I'm gonna get a heavier weight so you guys can see what's going on. So this is a 2.2 pound weight. And pretty much from here, after you feel comfortable there, you're gonna get no more than 4 sets of 8 reps. So we're trying to create power. So we don't need to do sets of 10 or sets of 12. Power is we need to let our muscles recuperate. So you might wanna take like at least maybe like 2 minutes at minimum, okay, to let our muscles recuperate before we do another set. So when you're training for power, it takes time. So I'm going to take this ball and throw it and try to stop it. Now, in slow motion, as I'll have you guys watch here, look at what's happening with my wrist. My wrist moves into a little bit of wrist extension, which the wrist flexors are eccentrically controlling that. They want to stop that and move it back into wrist flexion. Again, it's going to help us get better wrist velocity, maybe increase ball velocity as well. So there it is. You guys can increase the resistance of this by getting a heavier load. So TheraBand makes weights. This is a 3.3 pound weight. The next one up is a 4.4, I believe, and then a 5.5 weight. And that should be enough to get a training effect at your shoulder and at the front of your elbow and your wrist.
Do you want to know the secret to preventing baseball elbow pain and throwing harder? Then click here and download my free report, the number one exercise to prevent baseball elbow pain before it starts and get rid of it if you have it, that you can use immediately.